Hello, you fairy fools! Jim Sterling here, and this is ORC Slayer. The title screen alone is impressive, as I'm just watching these orcs over there on the fence, just kind of tumbling into each other. This is a first-person shooter, of all things, and I feel kind of sorry for it, because you normally, you know, even a crap game, and an obscure game on Steam, after it's been out for a day or two, will have reviews. This has none. This has no feedback whatsoever, so I feel kind of bad for it. But we're going to see if it's good or not. We're going to give it a go now. ORC Slayer. Centuries ago, there was a great war. Much of that, I'm not going to read all that. I will apologise if my voice cracks at any point today. It's been quite a day already so far. I shot my voice a bit because I was recording. I do a podcast called Fist Shark Marketing. If you go to fistsharkmarketing.com. You can find out all about that podcast. It's basically about a bunch of corrupt corporate marketing executives. And I played an alternate character to what I normally play on the show this week. And it involved very gravelly screaming. And it's really hurt my throat. Good job I recorded my Gymquisition audio before all that. But it's not sounding too bad. It does hurt, though. So that was fun. Also, I had to change my Gymquisition on the fly. Can we just skip this? Nope. Oh, there we go. Normal. Had to, fucking hell. Hold on. Why is it doing that? I don't know what. It's just going on its own. Let me unplug the controller, because I got that on. That might be the problem. Hold on. Right, I've unplugged the controller. I want to use mouse and keyboard anyway. Nope. Still going at it. Looking up and spinning around. I think I might need to restart. Sometimes games do this. If a controller's already plugged in, they just go haywire. So, let's try that again. Bloody hell. We're starting off strong. Okay, we're back and it's stable. That was the problem. We had a controller already plugged in that just made it lose its marbles. So here we go, ORC Slayer. Don't know what exactly we're doing around here, but you can shoot at a chicken, so that's something. I guess it's gonna try. Oh yeah, it's trying to attack us. We'll have to kill it. Okay, apparently that equals health though. So there we go, turned into a chicken leg. Took a little while. E to bash. Maybe not. Oh no, we need this first. There we go. Okay, so no, it's not E to bash so much as it is E to select it. So that's your weapon swap. Headshots equals an atom. G does something with atom. And then there are orcs and a tower. I'm learning a lot from this tutorial. That's good. Don't know, as I was saying before I was interrupted by the game being weird, I had to rewrite the gym. There is a Gymquisition topic that I've been wanting to talk about for years. Every year around this time, I plan to do it and I never do it. I finally got it wrote and recorded this week. And then something came up because I want to talk about something in Fallout. The embargo for Fallout is lifted for reviews before I normally post Gymquisition. So I'm taking that as an opportunity to talk about something in Fallout 4 for Gymquisition this week. Because Fallout 4 does something very personally interesting. Surprisingly interesting. And at this point, I obviously cannot say whether it does that in a good or bad way. But it is something I felt very compelled to talk about. So that'll be the subject of that tomorrow. And, you know, it's kind of timely and relevant. Then again, the other thing was timely and relevant. But it won't be. I might just do it next week, even though it's not at the time I was going to. Oh, this is rapid fire. Sorry, I see crossbow. I don't assume rapid fire. Alright, stop being rapid fire. I guess that's denoted by something. So, it's one of those games where you run forward a little bit and then have to keep running back because things keep spawning. But that's not really what we want to do, because I guess we want to destroy this thing. Maybe not. Maybe if I hit it with an X. Oh no, what's that G thing? Oh, this is leveling up. Sharper the bolts, the more they sting. And upgrade zones with slaying orcs, collecting experience, etc. Reload speed. Alright. Bolt sharpness. Flame on burn lock. Okay. Now what? Is that it? Okay. I guess that's it. These orcs are kicking the shit out of me. I get this chicken though. I'm wondering if maybe I gotta chop it with an axe. Doesn't seem to do anything. They don't look much like orcs. If I'm being honest. God damn it. To be honest, I don't think the pictures did a good job of telling me what I'm supposed to do. I mean, I'm assuming that means I've got to kill all the orcs before I can go past. Or maybe that is it. Maybe I don't have to destroy anything. I've just got to kill as many orcs as... No, there's loads of them. They just keep spawning up. Okay, so I think I've worked out what the issue is here. The tower has shrunk considerably in the time where you've not been with me and I've just been wailing on orcs. So it really is just a slog fest, I'm guessing, to get it to respawn orcs until it runs out. What are you doing trying to strafe around me, you cheek? Fuck off! What a cheeky prick! It's not even hitting it! Some of that, you fucking bellend! What a prick. I'm gonna shoot these chickens. No, I need your delicious chicken meat! There we go. Let's do some more blade sharpness there. That's about the best we're getting. Alright. Doesn't seem to make much of a difference, really. Either they die in two hits or they die in a headshot. And that's about the size of it. Getting some health back, scoring some Boko headshots. Feeling pretty good about that. Well, I was just about to call it, but no, there are yet more orcs getting in my way. Alright, how about now? Let's check on that tower situation after we deal with this fucking knob cheese. Well, its little glowy thing's gone. Okay. Is that it? Yeah. Okay, progress. Sweet, sweet progress. Now we get to do it all over again, presumably. I mean, I'm a fan of wave-based gameplay. Oh, fucking hell. But this is taking it a stretch too far. I swear half the time it's not hitting them when it should. It's not like me to blame a game for my own shittiness. I'm more than happy to take it on the chin. You know, whichever one of my chins you want me to take it on. But this is dodgy to me. do not stop. This is quite dull. You know, people getting bored of the first-person horror game, some like first-person shooter. Get a bit of action going, yeah? Let's thrill the people. It didn't thrill anyone. I don't know why I'm checking that upgrade. I think I've got to wait for the yellow bar in the corner to fill. Takes a while to fill. Oh, there we are. We got a rapid fire pickup. See, honestly, I feel like the game would be a lot better if the rapid fire was just par for the course. If that was the normal state of affairs. Otherwise, it makes this very slow going and ponderous. I'm not a big fan of games that make you just, like, run backwards constantly. So where it's, like, one step forward and a million steps back. Can't say I'm fond of it. Okay, can't really break anything. Fair dues. Fair dues indeed. Are we done here? The thing at the beginning said two towers. So, well, are these tower orcs or are they just orc orcs? Who can tell? So, I'm feeling a little less sorry for the fact it's gotten no attention at all. Kind of regretting my own decision to give it some. Now, some people have been asking this. Actually, the PR people have been asking this as well as fans, about whether or not I'm going to be covering Pathologic HD. I intend to. I've actually had it downloaded for a while. It's a timing thing. Between Fallout 4, which obviously I can say I've been playing now for quite some time, and Call of Duty, and I'm expecting a review copy of Rise of the Tomb Raider. Now, I won't be getting my review of that up at the same time as everyone else, but we'll be working on that. But between all that, it's been rough. It's been work this week. So, something like Pathologic HD, I'd like to do a video of, but I want to get to grips with it a bit, because I've only ever had a minor encounter with Pathologic before. The last time I tried to play it, I was suffering from a massive migraine, which I don't get so much these days now that I'm off the caffeine. Which is good for me. And I didn't get to grips with it enough, and I want to get to grips with it first before doing any potential video on it, because I feel it deserves that much. You know, that's maybe a little bit of special treatment on my part, but it's a game I've always wanted to try, and I want to try it properly. And I reserve that right to do so. We really not upgraded yet? No. What a bollocks. I think these guys are taking more. Like, it's two headshots now, I'm sure. Which just makes it even more of a bloody slog. But anyway, that's on the cards. And I know there's that one Xbox, zealot. Like a real holdover from the console wars of 2000, like the mid-2000s. Always weird, it's like seeing an ancient being from a past era. He's furious because I've not reviewed Halo 5. I talked about this on Podquisition, which is the Jimquisition podcast that you can also listen to with your ears. And I said on Podquisition, like, I didn't review Halo 5. Halo fans ain't gonna be happy about it. Not because I can guarantee that whether or not I'll like or dislike the game. I'm indifferent right now because I've not played it. But my knowledge of Halo, well, let's just say people got really pissed off at Angry Joe for admitting he hadn't played Halo 4 or whatever one it was. And they're like, how dare you review Halo 5? Once they see how ignorant I am when it comes to Halo lore and the Halo universe, there will be blood. And I'm going to play it for laughs, and I'm going to proper play up the ignorance as well. And I'm going to have a lot of fun writing that review, probably. But I need to go out and buy Halo 5 to do that. So, that'll be on my to-do list after I'm done, I guess, with Tomb Raider. That's just what I'm up to, reviews-wise. You know. Still haven't got any D&D or stuff like that I can update you on, because thanks to all the review stuff that's been happening since October, my Saturdays have been sharp. So I've not been playing any of it. Turning into another Uncle Jim story time, this video, mostly because the action is just so fucking mind-numbing. That's fine. I love talking about myself. So, should be an interesting gymquisition tomorrow. I'm very curious as to how people are going to take it. But that's as tantalizing as I'll be. And, you know, I've got an overriding temptation to talk about my review and Fallout 4 in general right now, but I am bound as a gentleman who made a gentleman's agreement to hold off until tomorrow morning. It's a good, good time to tell you that, of course. Tomorrow morning, I think it's like 7 a.m. my time, like 1 p.m. British time, I think. Basically, tomorrow morning, keep an eye out on thegymquisition.com. If you care about my review, you know, you might want to hear what Polygon has to say, or, you know, if you want, you can do that. Yeah, all of this. But I'll have a review up. And, you know, I've got footage recorded for a squirty play at some point later that day. So, tomorrow's going to be a big day. It's going to be a big Monday. My usual gymquisition. What the fuck? Oh, it's this. My usual gymquisition. And what other things we got? Flame on burn longer. I haven't even done this burning stuff. Thunderstruck. Upgrade the bolt at extra strikes. Earn upgrade stones by slaying orcs. When you fill the yellow bar, you'll earn a stone. Well, that seems like a good idea. We'll do that. Anyway, big day tomorrow. Looking forward to it. A little bit nervous. I always get this. That's just my own silly angst that comes in. You know, I've talked about my silly angsty problems before, but they just crop up when I know I've got a big. Big content day coming, and I don't know how people will enjoy that content. No, it matters a lot to me, you know. Hits and traffic and all that stuff is obviously not so important to me these days as someone whose main method of employment, I guess, comes from crowdfunding. But knowing people are enjoying my work, and the things I say, you know, are being enjoyed by people and, you know, all that stuff. That is important to me and will always be important to me. So I always get a little bit... always makes me want to pop some anti-anxiety meds or something when I wake up in the morning just to just take the edge off. That's enough about me being candid anyway. I know not everyone cares. I know not everyone cares. What other buttons have we got? Oh, that's the fire one. There we go. That's an interesting. Well, I actually hesitate to use the word interesting, but I'll say one thing. Black Ops 3's campaign is more interesting than this. So, I guess back to that. So that was some stuff that happened. I'm gonna go back to the fire. I don't think I can go back to the fire. Alright, whatever. Whatever! Actually, quite far away from the microphone for some of that. I apologise. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, my review for Call of Duty Black Ops 3 went up yesterday. I actually didn't talk about the PC version just because I think that there is a meta-bombed article in that I might come up with later today on thegymquisition.com. Figured that deserved its own little story. The game's rather disappointing launch at PC. So anyway, that'll be fun. Oh god, there's some bastards up there. What the hell? Oh, it's reverse controls. Oh, that is the dick move. It's always the dick move, is reverse controls. Pow, pow, pow. I'm gonna pow this chicken. So I get some chicken meat. Oh, fuck nuts. Oh god, there's more of them! What the bollocks! Should have upgraded my sharpness. Too late now. Oh, this is tiresome. This is really tiresome. Oh, you've died. Thank God for that. I'm actually not cut up about that. I'm going to go. Yeah, so I'm going to maybe give my little throaty-woaty break now. I'll probably be back later with another video. And maybe get, like I say, that meta bombed up on the Gymquisition. Just as I get prepared for tomorrow's big onslaught of Gymquisition Fallout 4 review. It's going to be quite a day tomorrow. I'm looking forward to it. I really am looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a fun day. Personally, and from just seeing how other outlets talk about the game and seeing the general thrill and drama that comes with big game reviews. So it's a particular joy of mine. Not that I don't like being on the receiving end of bullshit and hate from people, but seeing it happen and just seeing how wacky people can be, if I'm not involved, I don't mind looking at it. Fingers crossed I won't be involved, but we'll see tomorrow, won't we? So I'll speak to you then. This game was rubbish.